نحمده تعالى ونستعين به ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا وأستاذنا سيدنا وسيد الأولين والآخرين محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه، وارض اللهم عن سادتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن تابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. ثم أما بعد، my dear beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, it is indeed an honor and privilege to be among the believers in this great city and in this beautiful community, bringing to you, my dear beloved brothers and sisters, warm greetings and love from Egypt, the land of Al-Azhar al-Sharif. Bringing to you also best wishes for this beautiful community to flourish and prosper under the wise leadership of all the brothers and sisters, led by our beloved teacher and leader, Dr. Musharraf Hussein al-Azhari. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this community prosper and flourish to spread the beautiful message of Islam. Ameen. My dear beloved brothers and sisters, as you all know, that we are living amidst serious challenges. Serious difficult times at all levels. On one hand, Islam, our faith that has brought peace and stability to human civilization, is now being accused of terrorism, is being associated with violence because of the act, or acts rather, of idiotic people who have nothing to do with our faith, except by names. On the other hand, we are seeing that Muslim communities all over the world are facing also crises and challenges. We are seeing also a steady rise in Islamophobic rhetoric, something we have been listening to and viewing days in and days out. All of these difficulties, my dear brothers and sisters, can drive some of us into the state of despair and helplessness, can drive some of our young people even to leave the faith altogether. وَلَيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. But as Muslims, as practicing Muslims, as followers of our beloved Prophet ﷺ, we should always identify the silver lining in the dark cloud. This is the attitude of a Muslim. He never loses hope. But the hope I'm talking about, my dear beloved brothers and sisters, is a positive, proactive, active hope, not a wishful thinking hope. And there is a big difference between a positive hope and a wishful thinking. And in this khutbah, we are talking about sort of a roadmap of what a positive hope is all about. Learning from the Sunnah of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, our great teacher, who is sent, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in the Quran, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We sent you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as a gift of mercy for the entire world. And when he defined himself sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, إِنَّمَا أَنَا رَحْمَةٌ مُدَّى. I am a gift of mercy. And each student of knowledge, for those of you who know of seminaries and schools and madrasas from all over the Muslim world, a typical student of knowledge, when he goes to pursue his Islamic studies, the first hadith that this student of knowledge learns, الراحمون يرحمهم الرحمن تبارك وتعالى يرحم من في الأرض يرحمكم من في السماء. This is the first piece of information on the ladder of Islamic knowledge that he or she learns is the caring people are the ones who will receive the compassion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be merciful and compassionate for the people on earth so that the one in heaven will show compassion to you. This is our faith that is being discredited and that is being misperceived lately. It is the religion of mercy. So I'm sharing with you, my dear brothers and sisters, five symbols our beloved Prophet ﷺ taught us. And these five symbols, if comprehended and applied in the prophetic model, it can help us deal with the so many challenges we are facing nowadays. Very quickly, I'm going to mention each aspect and what is the moral behind it, with the hope that inshallah after this khutbah it will trigger further thought and we can talk more about this prophetic action plan to deal with the challenges and crises we are going through. The first is a famous hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam talked about in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim. Very strong hadith. And it is known as the hadith of the ship. Hadith is safina in Arabic. In which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gives us some sort of a parable or a story in which believers go to the ship. Some of them go to the upper deck and some of them go to the lower deck. And whenever the people in the lower deck need water, they have to go to the people in the upper deck to take water from them. So the Prophet continued to teach us that some idiotic person from the lower deck had an idea of digging a hole in the ship so that he could access water directly. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and this is the moral now, if we leave this person to make or to dig a hole in the ship, what is going to happen? Is he going to drown by himself? What is going to happen? Everybody will drown. If we cannot stop him and prevent him from creating havoc in the ship, everybody will drown. This is the example of believers. All of us, my dear brothers and sisters, are practically in one ship, the ship of this deen. We have to look after each other. We have to bring some unity and collectivity to our affairs. But at the same time, we have to prevent some of us, unfortunately, who would like to create havoc in this ship. If we are going to sail safely to the shore, we are going to do it all together. If we start bickering and fighting, if we start getting divided, and we say we will care only about ourselves, we will all drown. So the message I'm bringing to you, my dear brothers and sisters, we cannot afford to be divided at these times of intense challenges. We cannot afford, we do not have the luxury of being divided. We have to look after each other. And we have to prevent some of us who would like to create havoc to this ship. The second is the famous hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, which a person came to him with his she camel and told him, Ya Rasulullah, should I tie my she camel or set it loose? And then the Prophet ﷺ told him and corrected this understanding. He said, tie your camel and trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In other words, if you just keep the she camel loose, thinking that Allah will take care of everything, without doing your effort, without doing your share, chances are you are not properly putting your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Putting your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one of the most important actions of the heart. But you have to take the necessary means to do so. In other words, just sitting on your jamamaz and wishing that everything will work out will not do it, my brothers and sisters. We have to ask ourselves, what is it that we are asked and commanded to do to bring about the trust of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a complete form? The third, my brothers and sisters, is the famous hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in which he said, اتقوا النار ولو بشق تمرة. اتقوا النار ولو بشق تمرة. Guard yourself from the torment of hellfire, even if you have to spend half a date in charity. Half a date in charity. What is the moral of this important hadith? Do not belittle any good that you do. You never know. The little good that you do might be your ticket to paradise. Just keep doing it, putting your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you should be sincere. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam informed us, even the morsel, the little bite of food that one puts in his spouse's mouth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring it up. On the day of judgment, it will be like the mountain of Uhud, so huge. Just keep doing good, my dear brothers and sisters. Do not worry about seeing the fruit of your action. Allah has taken care of it. Allah has promised us, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيعُ أَجْرَ مَنْ أَحْسَنَ عَمَلًا. Allah will never put to waste the good deeds of the righteous people. That's a divine promise. That's a divine promise. Don't question about it. Just our homework is keep doing good and do not belittle any good that you do. Don't worry about the fruits of the actions because Allah has already taken care of it. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيعُ أَجْرَ مَنْ أَحْسَنَ عَمَلًا. The fourth symbol is the symbol of the axe. A man came to the Prophet and told him, Ya Rasulullah, I'm in need of money. The Prophet did not give him money, but he gave him an axe. He told him, here is the axe, go to the desert and earn your livelihood. Because he saw that he was a strong man. He told him to earn his livelihood. Muslims, my dear brothers and sisters, are not parasites on societies. Muslims, throughout the shining Islamic history, were pioneers of civilization. Muslims, throughout the shining history of Islamic history, were the people who contributed positively to the well-being and the welfare of societies. A good Muslim is the one who contributes, who always have something to share, who always have some skill to benefit not only the Muslims but humanity. And look into the example of Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam to tell you this story. The last point, it's a beautiful point, the example of the seed in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us, if any one of us is going to live around the time in which the day of Qiyamah is going to take place, if he has a seed or if she has a seed in his hand, if he can plant the seed, he should do. This is a powerful lesson. And this is what we mean by hope, is that we keep doing good deeds until our last breath. These are the 5 points I wanted to share with you, my dear brothers and sisters, so that we are encouraged to follow the example of our beloved Prophet. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم استغفروه فالتائب من الذنب كمن لا ذنب له. اللهم اغفر لنا.